In this video, I'm continuing on with the KutaSoftware Infinite Geometry free worksheet using similar polygons. There will be a link in the description below so you know how to get to this free worksheet. Now, our directions for this part say that the polygons in each pair are similar and we're to find the missing side length. And number 7, we're going to be using a scale factor. Now, the scale factor is the ratio of the side length of one figure to the side length of another figure. So if our scale factor is 2 to 7, our ratio is 2 over 7, where 2 is going to represent the smaller figure and 7 is the larger figure. So our smaller figure A, the side length is 6, and the larger figure B is our unknown, which will make x. Now, we'll cross multiply. We'll multiply 2 to x and 7 to 6, and then solve for that side length x. 2 times x equals 7 times 6. So 2 times x equals 7 times 6, which is 42. And when I divide by 2, I'll get that x is equal to 21. Since 2 divided by 2 is 1, 1 times x is x, and 42 divided by 2 is 21. So 21 is our missing side length in number 7. In number 8, our scale factor is from A to B, and that scale factor is 2 to 3. So we have 2 over 3, and from A to B, the missing side length y over the known side length 12. Cross multiplying, 2 times 12 will equal 3 times y. 2 times 12 is 24, and that equals 3y. So when I divide by 3, I'll get that 8, since 24 divided by 3 is 8, is equal to y, since 3y divided by 3 is 1y. 8 is our missing length in number 8. In number 9, the scale factor from A to B is 5 to 6. So we'll have 5 over 6, and that's equal to the missing side length in A, which we'll call x, over the corresponding side length in B, 30. Cross multiplying, 5 times 30 will equal 6 times x. 5 times 30 is 150, and that's equal to 6x. When I divide by 6, I'll get that 25 is equal to x. So 25 is my missing side length in number 9. In number 10, I have that the scale factor is 1 to 7, so my ratio is 1 over 7. And that's equal to the known length of A, which is 7, over the unknown length B, which we'll call P. So 1 over 7 equals 7 over P. Cross multiplying, I'll get that P equals 7 times 7. So P is 49. In number 11, the scale factor is 2 to 3. So my ratio is 2 over 3, and that's going to be equal to the side length of A, which is our unknown, x, over the corresponding side length in B, which is known, and that's 9. Cross multiplying, I'll have 2 times 9 equal to 3 times x. 2 times 9 is 18, and 18 is equal to 3x. Knowing that 18 is equal to 3x, when I divide both sides by 3, I'll get that 6 is equal to x. So 6 is our solution in number 11. In number 12, the scale factor from A to B is 1 to 2. That's equal to the unknown length of A over the corresponding length in B. Our unknown length, let's call this y, over our known length 6. Cross multiplying, 1 times 6 equals 6, 2 times y equals 2y. Dividing both sides by 2, I'll get that 3 is equal to y. In number 13, our scale factor is 6 to 7. And it's the scale factor from A to B. So this side A over the corresponding side in B. A is our unknown, so let's call that x, and B is 35. 6 times 35 will equal 7x. 6 times 35 is 210, and that's equal to 7x. When I divide both sides by 7, I'll get that 30 is equivalent to x. And that's the solution in number 13. And number 14, since A and B are similar polygons, the scale factor from A to B is 1 to 3. So 1 over 3 will equal the length of one side in A to the length of that corresponding side in B. Our unknown in A, let's call this R. R will be over our known length of 27. Cross multiplying, I'll get that 27 is equal to 3R. And when I divide by 3, I'll get that 9 is equal to R. So 9 is my solution in number 14. And I'll go ahead and stop the video here. Continue on to the next video where I'll solve for X and finish out this worksheet. If you haven't already, click that subscribe button and give me a thumbs up.